Hi viewers, welcome to Learn Matlab Basic. Today we are going to see about how to use PID controller in Matlab Simulink. So for that I am going to take one transfer function. So g of is equal to s plus 3 divided by s into s plus 2. So I am going to design PID controller for this particular transfer function, particular plant. So for that I am going to create that plant first. So for that, just go to type transfer fcn, and then here you have to provide the numerator coefficients, right? That means coefficient for s power 0 and s power 1, and then denominator coefficient. So here denominator coefficients are 0, 2 and 1. That means x square plus 2s plus 0, okay? So just go to multiply s inside, so you will get x square plus 2s plus 0. So you have to provide that coefficient of the denominator, okay? So you see that transfer function s plus 3 divided by s square plus 2s. So now I'm going to provide some constant input, and then I'm going to check the output of the system, okay? So I'm going to provide the input 1 to the system, and I'm going to check the result of the system. So here we are going to use two inputs. So I'm going to measure output and input, okay? And here I'm going to check the results of the system. Now you can see that we are providing input 1, but output is keep on increasing with respect to time, okay? So that means output is not maintained constant in the plant, okay? If suppose you want to maintain the output at a particular value, right? Like you have to maintain it to 1 per unit, or 1 that one 1 amplitude of 1, or amplitude of some other value, right? So then we need to implement some control logic, okay? So first I'm going to implement P controller, professional controller, right? So for that I'm going to use sum block here, sum, and then I'm going to connect. So I'm going to consider reference. So reference 1, that means I'm going to maintain output of this plant always equal to 1. So that's why I'm putting the reference equal to 1 here, and then I'm going to take feedback from the system. So this is known as feedback control concept. So here we are, I'm going to use the negative feedback control. So normally for closed loop control, if you have to control the output of the sum system, so we need to use negative feedback control logic. So here I'm going to use negative feedback control logic, okay? So here I'm going to measure the output of the system, and then reference input we are giving. So I'm simply using that the error between reference and actual is given to that plant, right? So here I'm putting some gain here. So the gain, so this will be act as a professional controller, right? So here I'm going to simulate the model and then check the result. So now you can see that, so when I'm going to put kp equal to 1, so this is proportional gain. So you can see that system will be settled at that means it tried to maintain at 1 pair, that means amplitude of 1, right? So it will track the reference command. So plant having the output of that reference, right? Okay, so now I'm going to increase this one. 1 can be increased to 10. So I'm going to increase to 10, and then we will check the response, right? So when I'm going to increase the PI, so you can see that it has some peak overshoot, but it will be settled quickly. So when compared with the previous one, okay? So when you are going to increase the gain of the professionals, that means professional controller, then it will be settled quickly, as well as a peak overshoot will be arises in the system. So now I'm going to use PID controller from the MATLAB. So I'm going to use PID controller, and here I'm going to connect. So here you can choose the controller, different controller. So first I'm going to use only P controller, that means professional controller, and then test the response, right? So So already we test the response, right? Again we got to test that one. So we are getting same response. So again I'm going to increase the gain of this is proportional controller. I'm going to check the response. So now you can see the changes in the response, right? It have a peak, overshoot, and then settle quickly. So now I'm going to use integral controller. Okay. So I'm going to put gain of the integral controller is 1. Okay, and then I'm going to check the response here. Here you can see that the system having oscillation, right? So because we didn't finding the integral gain value, so without we are used to default value. So now I'm going to use 0.1, right? Instead of 1, I'm going to use 0.1 and then check the response. So you can see the changes in the system, right? Say again I'm going to reduce the integral gain to 0.01 and then you can see the response. Okay, so this is a variation of integral controller. So we need to find the exact value for that the gain of the integral, right? So now I'm going to combine a professional and integral controller. Okay, so here I used 10 and here is 0.01 and then you have to check the response. So again you are getting same kind of response as it is in the professional controller, but we have some slight changes. So I am going to adjust this gain value now. So here I am going to put 1 for the integral gain and then I am going to check the response. So you can see the small variations, right? So I am going to use here, I am going to use 1 and 1 here, both are 1, and then check the response. Okay, so you can see that variations, right? So based upon the value of KP and KA, right, so you will get the response, different response, right? So you can tune this response also, right? So how you can tune this response? Just you have to use tune, right? There is a PID tuner app is available in the MATLAB, so you can tune that PID controller. Okay, just you have to click tune. After that it will be open another window. Okay, yeah, this is the window. So here I'm going to click identify new plant. So after clicking identify new plant, or else you can use this one, PID tuner, directly, right? So here you can see that. So don't go for identification process because the system is already linear system, so no need to use that identification process. Okay, so directly you can use the tuning system, right? So here you can see that the dotted line is the block response, so this is the tuned response, right? We can adjust this one. This mean here you can see that you can adjust two slider, that mean response time and the transient behavior. So I'm going to adjust the transient behavior. So here you can see that, and then you can adjust the detail also. So we can adjust this one, we can see that variation of P and I, right? So now I am going to update this model and then check the response. Now you can see that we are getting exact response, right? So by adjusting this response time, so you can adjust the response, whatever exact response you want, so you can take that response, right? So here you can see that, so this is a response we are getting. So by adjusting these two parameter, right, the response time and the transient behavior, so you can make that system response as per our requirement, right? So this is the way we can adjust the PID controller parameter exactly. Okay, and then so this is a PI controller. So now I'm going to change to PID. Okay, so now I'm going to use PID and then here I'm going to use default value. So I'm going to use 1111 and then we have to check the response of the system. Now you can see that, so this is a response of PID controller, even though you are not getting exact response, right? Even though in PA, that means professional controller will be providing better results, okay? But PID is not giving perfect results because the tuning, we are not did any tuning, we are not find the value for KPK and KD. So you have to do that one. So just you click tune and then go for tuning method. So now we can adjust this parameter and then you can get the results as per your requirement. Okay. So now I'm updating the system and then I'm going to check the results. Now you can see that we are getting a perfect results. Right. Okay. So that means we are getting the results, right? You can see that settling time also, right? So it will be settled quickly, right? But it is having some error around, is not a that mean error, that means is around 0.0001, right? Okay, so we are getting the exact output, and then that mean it will attract that reference command exactly. Okay, so by the way, you can tune this PID controller and then you can get the better results for the particular transfer function model. Okay, so by this way, you can use this PID controller for some other application. So this is working of PID controller in MATLAB Simulink. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe to the channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.